I never got to ride you in that big belly.
It's good, it's my favorite. All them cows are milking me. I didn't feel a thing. Stevie Christopher, who, friend of a friend, Canadian construction worker, who, made a whole CD of songs like this, and, gave them to, a lady, gave them to a lady, and as to, profess his love, and she did not respond.
Whoa!
Yeah, this is Metallica. This is actually Metallica. What's up, Claire? We got Daniel in the house. We got Josh. We got Chris. We got Trent and Steve and Nani. Whoa! What a grim theologian.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. Big bless to Dakota.
Oh, boy.
Big blast to you! Yes! To the Blue Rose Wretch! Bella's here! Matthew's here! Eldridge Grave!
Eldridge Grave! Eldridge Grave! Eldridge Grave!
Meredith in the sunshine!
Shreds!
I am with you! I am with you always! You should know this by now. I'm with you always. Oh, here, wait, here we go. And again, we will listen to it one more time, and then we'll start the stream. County, you say, huh? You find any Sasquatch tracks? Oh, you find a Sasquatch ass print? Yeah, we'd rather everybody was on Twitch, but it's just the way it goes. The party's on Facebook. What are you gonna do, you know? Todd's here. Todd.
We went for soda.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Yeah, I have a CD of toddlers screaming. I listen to that sometimes. It's pretty good. I enjoy it. Yeah, do both. Hey, I bless. Bless. I'll bless you on Twitch. I'll bless you on Facebook. I don't care. I'll bless you up. I'll bless ye. down, okay?
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Why? I never felt so lazy and I'm all out of time.
Why?
That's right.
Right, Bella. It's very late. Yeah, call the Primal Scream hotline and put your toddler on. I like that. I enjoy that. That's good for me. That's good for me. Sure. Probably smarter to not put a toddler on blast without permission. Let's do this instead, huh? Yeah.
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 Come on. Yeah.
Come on. Let's have some fun. Whoa! All right.
Wow. Everybody's here. Thank you. I put a lot of dirt in my hair. Balances out the grease because I don't shampoo. So. Oh, do you want to see the spout? That's from earlier. This is video from earlier when he was still in the car. He's doing great. He looked, oh no, I've disappeared again. I'll be right back. Of course.
For now. Look at the spout.
Well, it's fantastic to have everybody here. I feel good. It's another beautiful day on the Hold Space for My Tribe live stream. Welcome one and all. Gaze upon my son. He was my lawyer, then he was my lunch, and now he's my child. This is how it's going around here. If you'd like to see us, you know, this is what it looks like when we arrived. To catch everybody up here, this is what it was like when we arrived. Back here. Oh, and then the library was closed. If you forgot. I'll never forget. I can't forget. So anyway, that's where we are right now. Sorry, I'm just getting my corporeal form back online. You may have heard the Windows notification sound that it crashed. This is, of course, projected into your mind by your subconscious because we live in a technological society, and whenever anything goes wrong, we all hear either the Windows XP or Mac OS failure sound. It's just kind of how that goes these days. And then sometimes you got to come back online after a failure, you know, of your physical body. But it's not a big deal, and you can always do this, and you know, you can always come back online. I'm not back online yet, but hopefully I will be. Hey, there we go. Everybody, please say globule in the chat. As you can see, we're still here. We're still here in the library parking lot. I'm not leaving.
I'm not leaving.
I will not leave. So I've been sleeping here. We've got the spout. He's doing all right. He's a full grown man. Thank you for all the globules. Globule. I like that, Eldritch Gravy. That's very nice. So I'm still here. I'm still living in the library parking lot. It's hard. I'm sleeping on the ground. I'm just waiting for it to open again. So, you know, this is right now I'm streaming from my phone, from my Chopo phone. It's a Nokia. It's a Motorola Razr, actually. Sorry, I'm streaming to you right now from a Motorola Razr. And things are going pretty good here. I'm just, you know, waiting for things to open up. And I just want things to feel good again. I just want to be able to stream like I used to.
Whoa!
So that's all I'm waiting for. I don't know. Until then, you know, we'll see. I mean, I'm not sleeping well. I tell you that much. I'm really not sleeping well, and I'm not sleeping a lot. Not getting enough sleep.
I'm just waiting. You know, I think it'll all be okay.
I have been having trouble with digestion, so maybe let's see some things that I can do to aid my digestion. That's kind of a whole thing. So here we go.
I'm going to do some clockwork circles that are more energetic and relaxing on your belly. So you can, and it's as if you're looking at yourself and then there's a clock on you. So there's a clock on your belly and it's going in that direction.
And the clock's ticking. The clock's ticking on anything that you eat. This is what this is meant to symbolize. This is a threat. This is a threat to the food that you've eaten. TikTok, okay? Maybe you made it through the mouth. Maybe the enzymes in my saliva didn't take you out of the game, but TikTok, because here comes the bile.
Here comes the bile.
We do it backwards. So encouraging that movement.
And this is the thing, if you rub your belly in a counterclockwise motion, you actually reverse the time in your gastrointestinal tract, and you will not only vomit, but the food that you ate will reconstitute itself and once again exist as a source of nutrition for the outside world.
And maybe just close the eyes gently as you move in slow circles. Allow both the chest and belly to move.
I need some Tomalip and Thorn Scrub, please.
We even have some musical accompaniment here in the background. There's singing lessons going on next door. Yes. And imagine.
So if this is what you're into, boy, have I got good news for you. There's a website called YouTube.com where you can see this any time of the day.
And feel a sense of flow through your body. Make the circles even slower. Feel that flow in your digestive system from your breath.
Really make that Salisbury steak shake in its boots, in its little, I suppose they'd be leather boots. This is really what we're doing here. So, I mean, that's kind of all they do. I think they also just recommend just holding.
In order to stimulate a relaxation response. So maybe about twice as long. You could count or you can just feel that exhale. Really?
Instructions unclear. My digestive system made a TikTok, and now every shit I take gets thousands of views. There are worse situations to be in. I mean, hopefully you're monetizing this at the very least.
Release out every last bit that you can. Nice long exhales. And our digestive system, it's in a clockwork motion through our bodies.
Can you imagine if this was, I mean, if this really was recommended to rub, just to, after every meal, you have to rub your belly and breathe in and out real slow. You go to a restaurant, you know, would you like the check? Excuse me. No, I would not like the check. So anyway, JFK was, he either was an alien or he was murdered because he was going to blow the lid off of the whole alien thing. So let's get into that. Oh! Ah! Yeah! Wow. I like this. Press conference. Let me whisk you away to Copenhagen in the year 1991. Thank you for sharing the stream. It is, yeah. I mean, if you do that to your stomach, you'll probably continue to digest just fine. It's certainly the least harmful thing we've ever shown.
Rundt om i verden mener at der er
en
ordentlig stor sammenhæng. Vi har mødt et af dem.
Well, we're looking right here at the driver. Kennedy's over there. He's got an arm. His arm comes around.
You guys heard about JFK? Have you heard about that? Have you heard about him? Do you know about him? He was the alien who was going to blow the lid off the aliens, and so they manifested a bullet for him.
He's got a gun in his hand, and he fires the impact of the shot
You remember him?
Impacts Kennedy. There's his gun, and he fires. His arm, gun, fires on Kennedy. You'll see it again here, left arm coming round. And this is what it's shown like in the normal version, so it's very hard to see.
Who is the driver?
The driver is...
Yes, John F. KFC. John Fitzgerald Kentucky Fried Chicken, former vice president, you know, died in mysterious circumstances, was an alien, knew about aliens, and his head just did that. This is the MacGruber film. Yeah, this is the MacGruber film.
So William Greer is a Secret Service agent working for the CIA.
Der har igennem tiderne været mange teorier om, hvem der myrdede John F. Kennedy, og det har før været på tale, at CIA var indblandet. Men Ananda har en helt speciel grund til, hvorfor det netop skulle være CIA, der er mange teorier om, hvem...
You know, it's funny, I think that, you know, whoever killed JFK, if it was Lee Harvey Oswald or whatever, you know, I think he probably would have, like, live-streamed himself doing it, and in this, it would not be, we wouldn't have the mystery, because he probably would have put it on his Instagram.
...der myrdede John F. Kennedy, og det har før været på tale, at CIA var indblandet. Men Ananda har en helt speciel grund til, hvorfor det netop skulle være CIA,
like, this is,
der myrdede...
You know, this is probably like pretty grisly footage, but you can't, it's so low quality, it doesn't matter.
...amerikanske præsident.
According to the documents that were seen, President Kennedy had to be killed because he found out about the secret importation of drugs by the CIA and information concerning the alien presence, that is, that UFOs or crash disks had been recovered in the deserts of New Mexico with dead alien bodies.
So this is Ananda, this is Ananda, and Ananda knows all about the alien connection and the drug connection. It's probably one and the same. Listen, who said the aliens don't like to party?
Okay.
Who said that?
And he wanted to reveal that to the public.
For hele historien handler om rumvæsener. Ananda har i de sidste 6 år videt sit liv til at undersøge det, som han påstår er USA's og CIA's udvikling af teknologi med rumvæsener fra andre solsystem.
You ever had one of those? You go to get a massage and they put your wrist on the kind of like pastel colored glowing rectangle thing. They put it on there. It kind of hurts, doesn't it? It doesn't really feel very good. It always kind of tugs on my arm hair. I don't really know what the deal is with that. And then when I go home, I have like my hair is all staticky. And if I touch anything metal, I pass out for like, I don't know, a couple minutes. Does that ever happen to you? You go get a massage and then afterwards you touch something metal and you pass out for a couple minutes. That happens to me. I don't know why.
Projects could come for import and narcotica.
Well, this is according again to military personnel, as well as some documents that have been released. In 54, there's been a brief agreement made, apparently, with an alien nation, legal against the Constitution of America, that allowed the aliens to monitor human beings, that is, kidnap human beings, to monitor their for medical reasons, providing they didn't know they'd been abducted, and there was an exchange of technology. And that technology is being tested at a place called Area 51 in Nevada.
Yeah, I guess like I can't understand the other voiceover, so I don't really know if they're taking this guy seriously or what, but I do like that this was on television in 1991.
That means, according to your theory, they work together. CIA and the aliens work together. This sounds like, you know, a science fiction movie.
That's exactly how they want it to sound. That's the best way they can keep it a secret.
Wait, okay. So they want it to sound crazy, but it's not like they've changed anything about it. Like, yeah, no, they want it to sound like science fiction. Well, then what part did they make it more fictional? Like, that's just, no, that's how it is, and it sounds crazy, and that's how they're going to hide it, because it sounds crazy. Yeah, I mean, I can tell you some crazy things. It doesn't mean that I'm making them crazy so that you don't believe them.
De gjorde deres viden om disse transaktioner mellem USA og rumvæsenerne. Og Ananda har masser af kilder og dokumentation. Rumvæsenerne skulle blandt andet befinde sig i nogle underjordiske gange i Nevada-ørkenen, og for at holde sig i live har...
Is it just me, or does that seem more credible than, like, any image I could see online? Any PDF? To get those PDFs out of here! Get these PDFs out of my ears! Okay, I need Xeroxed documents or no deal.
De brug for sekreter fra mennesker eller dyr.
Incredible, but that's according to the military documents.
How do people react when you come and tell the story?
Generally, they're very interested, and at first, of course, it's hard to believe. But once they start seeing some of the documentation, all the pieces fit together.
Aren't you afraid that people think you're crazy?
No, I've not had that.
No. Never.
Ja, spændende er det i hvert fald. Ananda holder i øje.
I'm not super multilingual or anything, but I'm pretty sure that the news anchor just said, "What a fucking asshole." So yeah, if you want to check up on Ananda, you know, we won't spend a lot of time with Ananda, but you know, you are all commenting on the luscious head of hair.
To brain states and heart states, according to the research and studies of the HeartMath Institute, is a cycle of about 8 cycles per second, which is also the frequency detected by the Hessdalen Research Association in Norway.
The head of hair mostly hung on. I mean, this is, you know, hey, luck of the draw, but you know, just not as it doesn't seem to be as well taken care of as it used to be, but hey, who's got the time? Who's got the time, huh? So anyway, this is what JFK really looks like. And this was made with Easy Vid, so you know it's good. Okay, I'm sorry. We really got to take this from the top. Can we just rewind? John F. Kennedy, amphibian insectoid. So, yeah, a lot of people don't know this. They say F, but it's not. It's if. It's the F stands for if. It's John F. Kennedy because he was so full of potential and there were a lot of possibilities during his reign. So it's actually John F. Kennedy, and I'd appreciate it if we could all start saying that. He was an insidious incognito monster. This was recently discovered that he had an early build of Google Chrome. So back before his demise, he was actually using an incognito browser quite often, and this was in order to evade the CIA, because he was he did have a lot of information they didn't want him to have, and so he was an incognito monster. When they say incognito monster, that's because he was browsing monster.com in incognito mode. He was looking for new jobs. He had won the presidency. He wasn't happy about it. He knew his life was in danger, so he was using an incognito browser to browse monster.com. But with a spectrometer, one could identify the thing. So people could see that he had been using the internet by, you know, looking at sort of the light bouncing off of his skin. And that's him. That's So with the proper tools, you can actually tell that John F. Kennedy, shortly before any public appearance, he had gone to a county fair and had his face painted to look like a tiger. Was actually kind of what he used to do, but then he would hide that under a layer of makeup, which is, you actually need special devices to be able to see John F. Kennedy's tiger makeup. And it was always, you know, he would go to these county fairs, and it was like they're more used to working like on smaller faces. It's normally only children that have this kind of work done. So he'd say, you know, make me tiger. He'd say, I'm the president, make me a tiger. And they would say, okay, yeah, it's nice to see you again, John. You got a big meeting later? And he'd say, tiger, now, make me tiger. And then so, you know, yeah, here we go. And so he's sitting in the chair getting his face painted. He's looking for a new job on monster.com. And so these are the kind of things that you can really only... find this kind of information from secondary news sources. You're not going to see this on CNN. You're not going to see this on the History Channel, that JFK was a secret tiger face paint enthusiast. All right. So I don't know. There's still a minute and 23 seconds. Let's see where else this goes. Look at its eyes. They're nothing but globs of gunk. John.
Your eyes are nothing but globs of gunk.
Look at JFK toes. Look at JFK toes. They're deformed and freak. Look at him toes. That thing creeps. Look at that. You ever seen toes like that? I've never seen toes like that, man. Those things creep. Man, those things creep. You ever see JFK toes? Dude, those things creep. Those things
creep.
So it's, you know, hey, you heard it here first, all right? So he's looking for a new job. He's getting his face painted. And his toes, man, those things creep. Those things freaking creep. So, pretty cool stuff. You can only get it from me. Look at those things, man. Those things creep. And that's Tobey Maguire. This is actually kind of unrelated. This is more of a, like, world building. To add Tobey Maguire in here so that you think, like, what's going on with that? Why is Tobey Maguire there? You're supposed to think that. Pretty sneaky, sis. And here, yeah, I mean, you can just really get a sense of, like, this is a man who spends, you know, maybe 8 to 10 hours per week getting face paint applied, you know, and makeup on top of the face paint. So, like, the pores in his skin can't really breathe. It's kind of like that movie Big Fat Liar where Paul Giamatti gets covered in the blue ink. I read in Nickelodeon magazine that he felt like his pores were suffocating in all that the blue body paint. So this is a lot like that. This is Paul Giamatti, former President Paul Giamatti. And that's Herman Munster. Again, you're supposed to be thinking, what's going on? That's part of it. Really not doing him a lot of favors with these pictures, but this is sort of a hit piece. So, okay. Make Me Tiger, etc. There we go. If you want to know more, read ebook JFK VIP to RIP. That's maybe one of my favorite things I've ever seen. JFK VIP to RIP. So this is John F. Kennedy. Very important person to rest in person. Take a rest in person. Pretty cool stuff. So, you know, the holiday season, goodbye and have a nice day. The holiday season is right around the corner. So I hope that when your uncles and your, you know, and unfortunately some of your own parents, your own immediate family, start talking to you about, you know, what's really going on and, you know, all these things. I hope that you can bring them a copy of the ebook JFK VIP to RIP. I hope that you can show them that and say, yeah, yes. Yes, Uncle Ricky, I do know what's going on, actually, and I know it better than you. And I know that John F. Kennedy was a little tiger boy, and that's just how that goes. So, and we all know what the F really stood for, and that's if. It's actually John F. Kennedy, Uncle Ricky. You're not even saying it right. And we all know you aren't educated, Uncle Ricky. Here we go. You like reptilians?
On the internet, you can find all the information you need about this.
So this is this video is called Doritos Told Us About Reptilians. So I probably should have set that up. Here we go.
Theory that a reptilian race has infiltrated our society, substituted our leaders, and since Mesopotamia has guided the future of humanity.
If they're good or bad, I don't know.
Yeah, you can find everything on the internet except the Doritos mystery flavor.
So you can't. So this is the thing. Like, you know, we all think that there's some things that we really need to know about. Like, we really need to know about reptilians, but you actually need to know the Doritos mystery flavor. I also really like just the title of that video. You know, just like, you know. Because they're always dangling the hints right in front of you, man. They really are. Like, the elites are like, how do we hide the fact that we're all reptilians? I know. Let's just come out and say it. So how about that? And the comments are fantastic. Whoa, that was very interesting. Nice one. Truth Exposed 119 says thank you. And then this was posted on a channel called A Spiritual World Exist 2. And then we've also got a comment here saying, wow, this is something else. And this comment says it all. I know, right? They've been flashing the truth in our faces for years, but we just couldn't see it.
We just couldn't see it.
Do you know the Doritos commercial that told us all about the reptilians? We actually just couldn't see it. Okay, here we go. Let's call upon an ascended master. I had an idea. I don't know if I'll actually end up doing it. But to every week, maybe let's talk about a different ascended master. There's a lot of them. I don't know a lot about them. And there's many of them. And then also, you know, a lot of people didn't talk about that, but the Doritos mystery flavor that year was actually iguana skin flakes. That's actually all it is. So
let's get into the Ascended Master Truth.
There we go. This is a statement. Don't worry about it.
Beloved mighty and presence and beloved master Hilarion, descend with your cosmic...
So this is Ascended Master Hilarion, the drawings of Hilarion are always very funny. I'm a big fan. I'm a big fan of Ascended Master Hilarion.
Flame of cosmic truth in, through, and around my four lower bodies, especially my mental body, and feel unworthy. And cut me free from all human creation, now and for our eternity. Ascended Master Truth, blazes through me, and cut me free from all human creation, now and for our eternity. Ascended Master Truth, blazes through me, and cut me free from all human creation, now and for our eternity. Ascended Master Truth, blazes through me, and cut me free.
Blazes through me and cut me free. We like this. Okay, you know, the spooky season's coming around, so I think we should watch some TikTok, but maybe let's do that in a little bit. Let's talk about the lions.
I'm fearless but not reckless. They have big hearts and they stand strong in their truth. They like the challenges of the 3D.
Let's talk about Lyrans here, okay? Let me refresh.
These are the Lyrans. They come from Lyra. Some people think they're the oldest beings in the universe. They're really courageous and fearless but not reckless. They have big hearts and they stand strong in their truth. They like the challenges of the 3D, and they do exist in the 3D, but they also exist in the non-physical as well. I haven't had too much contact with the Lyrans, but what they did tell me is that they stopped working with the Anunnaki in ancient Egypt because they didn't like what the Anunnaki was doing to the Earth and to people. They're committed to helping humanity evolve.
Yeah, this is about the Elviras. They're alien beings, and they have like really big boobs, and they do like a lot of innuendo stuff, and there's like a pinball machine that like kind of involves the Elviras.
And not enslaving humanity. The best way I could describe them is they're divine like the Pleiadians, but primal like the Reptilians, but not in a bad way. They mean no harm. All felines are ancient Lyran beings. If you look into the eyes of a cat long enough, you'll start getting very activated by them if you're sensitive.
If you're sensitive and you stare a cat in the eyes, you're gonna get activated, okay? You're gonna get activated. And down here on planet Earth, we call that allergies, but it's not allergies, okay? If you're sensitive and you look at a cat in the eyes long enough, you're gonna start to feel some burning. You're gonna start to feel some itching, okay? You're gonna start sniffling. You might start wheezing, all right? You might have little red bumps all over yourself. This is a download, all right? This is just how it goes. Listen, I didn't tell you to live this way. I didn't tell you to live this way. And I don't work for Claritin. I don't work for Benadryl, so.
And they can share their wisdom and light codes with you. There's a few Lyran star seeds here. Some of my friends literally look like this. They have leader warrior energy.
Some of my friends literally look like this, man. It's crazy. I didn't want to hang out with them at first. I was pretty scared, but some of my friends literally look like this.
They fight for justice, but they could also be short-tempered and highly sexual as well. I love the Lyrans. Lyrans. They come from Lyra.
So there you go. Any questions? I don't know. Anybody got any questions? Probably, yeah, you probably do. But that's too, okay, that's fine. Here we go. Oh, how about this? This one's good. This is a Reiki slap. If you can't read that, it says, my Reiki healing love slap to help you clear negative energy. So here we go. Oh. Ooh. No. Stop that. Ouch. I did not ask you to do this. Stop it! Ouch! It's pretty good. Let's watch it again. And imagine this from the perspective of, you know, a spectator, not from the phone. Imagine watching a woman do this to her phone. Imagine it. Love slap. Here we go. Stop it, Mom. Very good comments here. That lady has a bug on her phone. Yep, you gotta make the most of it. Is it okay that I turned butt to face the camera? Yeah, sure, absolutely. Yeah, so there we go. Fakey. I do like that. That is fun. Okay, so I'm into music. I'm cool. I'm hip. This is my new thing. This is what I'll play if I were to, I don't know, maybe DJ a wedding or something. I think I'd put some of this on. It's very good. Pretty cool. I don't know. So this is a small sample of a live show. Hashtag tour. Hashtag goblin. Hashtag freestyle, hashtag metal. So this is for all the goblins out there. I know there's some of you fuckers in the chat. I know we have a couple of goblins. If you're a goblin, you know, don't say it. Definitely don't say it. Definitely don't say it. If you're a goblin. So my boss posts this guy a lot. Sick. He's cool. And this is why I'm not allowed on Zoom meetings anymore. All the meetings I'm on, I mean, they're all canceled. I'm working through email. Okay, only through email. Here we go.
Yeah.
Attaboy. Funky back.
pretty cool, pretty cool stuff. And a big thanks to our friend Mr. Wet Medicine, Jez Spirit, for these clips from TikTok. It's a big blast. Anybody catch the whatever that was we did with him a few days ago? That was fun. It was a jam. It was LTB and Jez Spirit making music. Pretty cool stuff. I was making dancing babies. Moving on, we're just blasting through. I hope this is all right with everybody. I mean, sometimes we do a deeper dive. I got some stuff later about the Nephilim. The Nephilim. If I ever have a nephew, definitely we'll be referring to him as a Nephilim. But I think we'll do that for the Patreon stream. So for now, let's hang out with Uncle Mike.
This communication device, I use this when I go into a trance. And then I talk to the crystal skulls that are under the caves, and then the caves under Critterville.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Pretty cool.
Crystal Skull One, come in.
Yes.
Did you get two?
This is the thing they don't tell you about the crystal skulls. There was a crystal shop in Mount Shasta, and they had a crystal skull. And I recall the owner or the purveyor at this crystal shop claimed that the first time they held a crystal skull, they grew to be 8 feet tall, and they started to glow like a light bulb the first time they held a crystal skull. So, but that's just one side of it. What they don't tell you is that when you talk to the crystal skull, they kind of sound like this. Come, crystal skull, coming in. That's actually what it sounds like, and it's supposed to sound like that.
Yes.
Did you get tuna fish or peanut butter? Thank you. Looks like we're taking orders for Subway. Crystal skull too. How's your grandmother?
So that's what TikTok's for, if you ever wanted to know. It's for Uncle Mike.
I'm just a singer in a rock and roll band.
So there you go. I mean, this video is hashtagged Critterville, hashtag vibing, hashtag FYP, hashtag insane. So, you know, why not? Why not have more?
Uncle Mike here. The third crystal skull stole the bluebird of happiness out of my bird cage.
Well, I'll tell you how the bird got out of the bird cage, Uncle Mike, because that's actually meant to hold toiletries in the shower or in the baths. And as you can see, there's no lid, and there's quite a bit of room there in between the bars there. You know, we should all rip some harsh bark with Uncle Mike. Definitely invite him to your Thanksgiving. And if he does indeed have a blue bird of happiness, then, you know, maybe we should get him an actual bird cage. I think if we all kicked in a couple of bucks, we could get him a functional bird cage, and he wouldn't have to use a bath caddy to store his birds. Okay, so this is, you know, it says, warning, Critterville Crystal Skull steals the blue bird of happiness. So that's just what's going on.
What am I gonna do? Help! 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 Somebody help me find my bluebird of happiness.
So I propose, or I would like to propose. I'd like to propose a minimum age requirement on TikTok, and I'd like that age requirement to be 55. I think you should have to be 55 to be on TikTok.
Uncle Mike here! What musical group told people to hold their heads up? Thank you!
I don't know don't know. I have just as many questions about who is filming, you know. This is the Ferryman. Not the Pharaoh man, but the Ferryman. Do you like when people do things like that? The Ferryman? Hi, like a postman, you know? I'm the Ferryman. That's what they actually used to call the pharaohs in Egypt. The Ferryman, yeah. I don't know, I just like that it's there. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it means. I just like that it's out here.
Detective Ferryman here. Well, this looks quite suspicious. Chief Detective Ferryman here. Well, this looks quite suspicious.
I don't know. Listen, okay, the Mr. Wet Medicine sends me the TikToks and I show them to you. That's what's going
on
here.
That's what's going on here.
That's all it is.
That's all it is.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Don't ask me questions. It's not what this is about. It's not about learning. You're not supposed to leave this stream with any kind of, with more understanding than you came in with. It's really not about that. It never has been, all right? So let's just, you know, let's just go ahead and talk about some Nephilim.
Yeah. I came to the conclusion that this cannot be a human being. It has to be something else.
We don't have that in our features.
This is what I like. What I like from, like, video content is I like videos of people looking at, you know, like itty bitty skulls or weird shaped stuff or like, you know, just shit that doesn't quite look right. And I like it when they say, you know, we don't have that. I like that. That's what I like. I like when they say, hey, that's not mine. That's not really what we don't have that. Wouldn't that make you feel good if you wouldn't that make you feel good if you went to a doctor and you said and you showed them, you know, like you had a big lump on your head and they said, we don't have that. You're not supposed to have that. You'd say, yeah, okay.
You can't push that back in anatomy. You can't do any kind of head manipulation.
And that's cheese bread.
To do that.
This could be a result of a genetic anomaly.
So this has to be genetic. This is almost like a new mutation line.
So
yes, it's definitely a genetic anomaly.
It is about a third, 30% larger.
And that's why it has to be genetic.
Right.
You cannot create this with pressures.
You can't pressure me. You can't ever pressure me. You actually just can't ever pressure me. You're not allowed. You're actually just not allowed to. So I'm just a fan of this. This is a documentary. This is a man who brings a weird skull to a bunch of different people and films them saying, well, that's not right.
I think we're looking at a whole different species.
And this you cannot make by more quailing. The skull.
This is definitely something that is genetic.
Another genetic anomaly.
Whoa.
I'm also a very big fan of the transitions, making like a big like every time something happens. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I like that. I'm getting sleepy, man. I keep, you know, and then I like too that there's a big like 30-second just blank here. That's pretty cool. I'm getting kind of sleepy, you guys. I don't know. I feel weird. Let's take a look at this big skull, though, huh? Now, show the big skull again. I mean, look at this. So you think... So the idea... Did everybody know the story of the Nephilim? Raise your hams. Raise your little hams if you know about the Nephilim. I'll wait. Anyway, I think the Nephilim were like some angels boned some human ladies, and then the Nephilim were the sons, and they're like giants. I think that's the idea with Nephilim. So this is what the skull looks like, it's because clearly it's, you know, angels, coneheads, one and the same. That's all it is. I don't know what he put at the end of this video, man. Just a mess. Just a mess is all it is. So now we're getting into our friend L.A. Marzulli. Okay, now, so here's some more L.A. Marzulli.
The story of the reptile called the Prince of the Power of the Air
is this real demonic power that forces behind these locations.
I heard a commotion and I turned around.
There's no question there's a spiritual implication.
Is it was built upon monolithic stones, which though it was originally a Nephilim stronghold.
So what we're seeing that little stick figure.
From the table was actually levitating by itself.
I bet whatever this show is, I bet it's not really very exciting. You know, it always happens this way. You get, you know, you think you're about to watch a cool show about something fun, and it's not. It's just not very cool. It just ends up being about some like normal ass shit. I will be the general of the Nephilim stronghold. Yeah, and of course, you know, you gotta hold your seed, man. It's just how it goes.
Besides, are Nephilim architecture have anything to do with fallen angels? And of course, that means demonic activities.
And something hits me right on my belt, knocks the breath out of me.
Damn. So that's on the trail of the Nephilim. I think that was from a dollar bill. So we like the Nephilim around here. This is just what we do. I've got more UFOs.
There's a subject that most people regard as fringe. The people in this film have seen something.
I've seen a UFO.
I've seen a UFO.
And I saw a UFO.
And I saw a UFO.
I've seen a UFO.
A UFO.
People from all walks.
Can we take a second, talk about the depth of field? Hey man, you know, I want this really to look good. Could you maybe give me like a shallow depth of field, something going on there? Just around my mouth. I know that doesn't even make sense because like my nose is further out than my mouth and then my neck, you know, but I just want like just a nice tilt shift. Can you just tilt shift on my mouth? I wanted my teeth to look teeny tiny. Hey, I know this thing's about aliens, but can we tilt shift on my mouth so that my teeth look teeny tiny? It'd make me really happy, man.
People from all walks of life have come on the record in their own words, and their testimony is true.
Join me as we explore the folks who have had encounters in their own words.
So what he does is he explores the folks. He doesn't, it's not just about talking to them. It's really about exploring the folks. Hey man, I'm gonna explore you. That's a crazy story. Let me explore you. Pretty cool. So these are all things from this L.A. Marzulli guy, which is pretty cool. Let's just get into him. Let's just do it. Or Yeah, let's get into that. Coming
to you from an undisclosed location somewhere deep in the heart of the Santa Monica Mountains, I'm your intrepid host, L.A. Marzulli. Today is September 13th. This is Politics, Prophecy, and the Supernatural Report.
You know it's all going to be politics, right? Like, it just has to be. When a guy says, like, it's just a little bit politics, it's all politics.
Of the Genesis 3:15 narrative, when we get to other passages, we don't know. There's no grid system for us to process those other passages. So Genesis 3:15 simply states this.
Finally, some real fucking news. I like imagining a situation where maybe you'd be at a bar or something during the daytime, of course, and you would hear someone say that. Finally, some real fucking news.
And the motif for what...
Let's just watch that over and over again. I don't really give a shit about what he's going to say, but I do want to watch him search for the words.
And the motif or whatever in the garden.
I really like that. He couldn't find the word motif.
Those other passages. So Genesis 3:15 simply states this. And
did you see the double? Did you see the mumwa? Can we? All right, we're going to slow it down. Sorry, everybody. Go get yourself a root beer and come back. We're going to watch the double mama like fucking 15 times. Here we go. Wait for it. Wait for the double mama.
Process.
Later. Enjoy your food.
Passages. So Genesis 3:15.
I mean, I'm a fan of... Man, I'm just this anyway, but...
We say this.
Genesis 3:15 says... So, and that's very important. You really need to know that. You really need to know that Genesis 3:15 says...
We say this.
It simply states it. It's not complicated. It's not. I'm serious. It's not. Can we all do our best Peter Kane impressions now? Can we do this? It's not complicated. It's not. I'm serious. I said it was normal. It was humiliating. No, it really was. It was. You don't believe me. No, it was.
And the motif or whatever in the garden.
He kind of does this a little bit of a second mama. Can we do it again?
The motif or whatever in the garden.
Because he wants to say motif, but he can't quite get there. So it's a mama. That's one of those. I like
You've
it.
Got the pre-incarnate Christ, the dragon, the serpent, and then over here you got Adam and Eve. And the pre-incarnate Christ says this to the dragon, you, your seed, your offspring, will be at war, at enmity with the offspring of the woman. The offspring coming from the woman, he will crush your head, you will bruise his heel. That sets up the rest of the biblical narrative. And
I like this idea of a pre-incarnate Christ. Like, when you think about it, Christ really couldn't catch a break. I mean, maybe that's a controversial opinion, but I think this Christ guy went through a lot.
What you're looking at until you're high above it. Now the drone there is probably about 60-70 feet up.
Wow.
Watch what happens when I pop the drone further up.
Pop
and you
it.
Really get a bird's eye view.
Pop
and you can
it,
see the entire undulation of the serpent.
Pop it. Come on, man.
Another shot of it right there.
So this guy's whole idea, he's like a biblical guy, he's a biblical man, I don't know, but he really believes in the Nephilim and he's patriotic, etc.
How would you check your work unless you're high above it? Well, it could have built three-story towers out of logs. Okay, I get that, they could have done that. But even then, when you're only up, you know, 30, 40 feet in the air, you don't get the entire, you don't get the full Monty. You don't really understand what it is that's on the Ohio landscape. And once again, I'll go
here. This is in Ohio.
And I'll just, right to there.
Serpent
Mound.
Where
the drone pulls up.
There you go.
And then you can really start to see what it is you're looking at.
I think he talks about the skull again.
In my opinion, In my opinion, this screams Genesis 3:15. This is what we're looking at. What is it doing in Ohio? What is it doing in Ohio? Chief Joseph had an interesting remark on
Chief
this,
Joseph.
Speculative conjecture on his part. He believes that this undulating serpent at one point in time could have been dressed with mica. So this whole mica would shine, would reflect the sunlight.
Tell us about the serpent mound. I'm interested to hear it. That's L.A. Marzulli.
Coming to you from an undisclosed location, somewhere deep in the heart of the Santa Monica Mountains.
Oh, yeah.
I'm your intrepid host, L.A. Marzulli, and this is On the Trail of the Nephilim. Thanks so much for tuning into On the Trail with the Nephilim. You can see we've got pictures of the book everywhere. A little overkill, L.A. But I want to get into this and talk about it in depth.
And he's got sponsors. But he just has this skull just hanging out.
The actual museum, like three times, maybe four. And I've led tours there.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, whatever. Let's get into the witch talk.
Some people think they're the old.
Let's get into the witch talk because I want to.
Dude.
Oh, hi, Jake. What are you doing here?
It started with the hay. Lost a creaking. Well, it just started in the hay. With his long johns on, Pop went a creeping out to the barn, up to the hay.
Here's the thing. The song Simiamawe by Rusted Root, always funny to me. Always very funny. And so this is a witch's TikTok. Cold is a witch's TikTok outside. Sounds like something my dad would say. So this is a witch talk. This witch is trying to get rid of this spirit. She's trying to send the spirit on its way. So here's Simi on my way.
I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run, how we will crawl. Simi on my way. Simi on my way. Simi on my way.
Me, Kaz.
So pretty cool stuff there. To Simi on my way. Rusted Root with Rusted Root. So Simi, just Simi on my little way.
Usually reading in my room. Spirit wanting attention. Knock it off. Wiggle wiggle. Throws book. Angry spirit.
So it's not the best, is it? It's to be on TikTok as a teenager. Not the best. I got the alien shit in my fucking mouth, man. Please don't leave me alone.
Fuck! They let you pick anything you want when you get down there.
And you landed on McLovin.
Yeah, I was between that and Muhammad.
Why the fuck would it be between that or Muhammad?
You know, I like this. I like this kind of mixing belief in demons with a pop culture reverence. This is kind of my... I love the movie Superbad, and I also do believe in making deals with the adversary.
Now that was a lot of damage.
Woo!
I'm having a panic attack right now. I need to calm the fuck down because I'm having a panic attack.
And you have to treat a car like you treat a woman.
Go on.
You know, and a lot of it hurts to watch. That's all I'll say. That's all I'll say, man. Spectre Ball. Spectre Ball. Oh, I listened to some new Spectre Ball the other day. It was pretty cool. It was about the pandemic. I think it was talking about being trapped. You know, it wasn't about like ancient serpents and stuff again. It wasn't quite about that. Can we, you know what? I want to watch the Spectre Ball video. Is that bad? Is that bad that I want to do that, even though we've seen it before and it's just something that I like. Let me put it on. It's called Ancient Serpents. Okay, we got an ad. We got an ad to wait through, kind of, but it's just how it's going to be, I guess. So have to wait through an ad or two. I think we can just jam out to Spectre Ball.
You cannot eat.
Oh, yes. Yeah. I think it's good.
Candle burns, empty shells.
I think it's good.
Drain the fear from me. From me. Mountain tops.
Yeah.
Raging seas.
Samael.
Ancient serpents, ancient vice, tree of knowledge, time to fight. On and on, the shadows come alive.
So good. I think we initially found out about Spectre Ball because he does make videos about the occult. This was posted by Retro Synth Records, not by Spectre himself. Oh, Samael. Okay, this is new. I guess he's got a video about are you predest by a Debid? Let's check it out.
Hey, I'm Spectre Ball. I am a gothic musician.
Let's do it. Come on, Spec.
And also, I am an occultist. And in this video, we're going to be talking about...
Are you possessed?
I'll show you how to get rid of it.
I didn't do that, okay? I didn't slow that down. I didn't do shit. I didn't do fucking shit to Spectre Ball, okay? He made this, not me.
Occultist. And in this video, we're going to be talking about...
Are you possessed?
I'll show you how to get rid of it.
Show me how to get rid of it. Spec?
Well, possessed. When I hear the term possession, I wonder, what can it be? Can a spirit come to me and possess my whole body? Well, that usually does not happen. What can happen is that...
It's just part of you? It's just what? Sorry, man, I can't come out tonight. My elbow is possessed. I keep extending my arm and contracting it, always towards the left-hand path.
You would speak to another individual, and they might have bad vibes, and those bad vibes attach to you. Other things that could happen.
Oh, dude.
You are open.
I want the Spectre Ball movie starring Nicolas Cage. That's what I want.
To the spirit world. And because the spirits know that you could hear and see them, they start bugging you. They just bug you. Other things that can happen. You created this possession. You created it by your thoughts of creating an egregore or thought form of this possession. And now you have to get rid of it. What do you do? Well, first thing is a middle pillar.
Oh.
Middle pillar connects you to your divine self or your daemon or whatever you may want to call it.
I like it when, occult words all kind of almost sound like other words. A daemon. I am possessed by a daemon. Could it be Samael? I just like it a lot. Yeah, I think you can meet and kiss Spectre Ball. I think he would really like that, probably. I don't know his number. I don't think he likes that.
Then you do a lesser banishing ritual with a pentagram to make sure that you clean out the space. If you don't know how to do that, you also can take salt, clear the corners. You could also use a singing bowl to actually use sound to clear the space that you're in.
Okay.
Because sometimes you might be projecting energy out that is negative. Now, what is the ritual? The ritual is a modified version of what I've read in Donald Craig's Modern Magic.
Mailer Diamond.
Great book. I suggest it. I do not get
that's funny.
Anything like from it, but it is a really good book. I will post the link down below. It is an affiliate link, so it will help the channel if you purchase the book. So, you create a circle. When you create the circle, you take your imagination and you form what you think. You make an image of the possessor in front of you. How it looks, sounds, feels. You could take a drawing, draw it out, and you place it in the circle with you.
Can we all just talk about how bad we want to kiss Spectre Ball and wanted to clear my space? I want him to clear my space. Well, this has been fantastic. I have had a very good time. I've had a
very good time.
Very good time. Thus concludes this stream, this normal stream. We have a Patreon that's at patreon.com/oldspace for my tribe right there, where I will continue. I think we're going to get more into Spectre. I don't practice Santeria. I don't need no Spectre Ball. Well, that's enough for me to feel good about the work we've done here today. On the Patreon, we'll continue to stream for another hour. Probably get just more and more and more
and more
into Spectre Ball. I mean, that sounds fun to me, and I'm pretty into it now after watching that. Thank you guys. So I love you. I love hanging out with you. Thank you so much. We'll see you again soon. And if you're a patron, give me, I don't know, man, give me 10 to 15. Give me 10 to 15. Give me 10 to 15. Give me 10 to 15.
And let's just
inspect your balls.